One of many children who have worked with other children to demand for our rights in our sub-county. I have represented my children in different occasions, both international and national. And last year I was invited in UNO General Assembly in New York to represent my fellow children about the MDGs, or the Millennium Development Goals. Last month I was also invited in Brussels to represent my fellow children. And now I'm back. So I thank God for that. I've been representing my fellow children on different issues, mainly on child protection, education, and health. I'm here to show the Millennium. I'm here to show the I'm here to show you the main important thing of listening to children. It's very important to listen to children because they are also having their views, and they are also having intentions of what they are also asking you to help them. Government leaders have not minded about children's issues. In other words, they have just left their voices to, or not to hear it. That's why we as Peace and Justice Club members, we decided to help most of the children in our sub-county and to uplift or raise their voices so that they can also be heard in different occasions and by policymakers. I would like to give an example of education. The number of teachers to pupil ratio had been low, whereby you would find 200 children being taught by one teacher. Can you imagine one teacher to teach almost 200 pupils, and you think that they can understand what is being taught? So some children have just been ending up failing because at the end of the lesson, they could not understand what is being taught. Then the performance has been low. In other words, pupils have been poorly performing, whereby the sub-county had never received any child passing in first or second grade. As children under Peace and Justice Club, after being in such situation, we asked ourselves how we could act upon this issue. Then we mobilized ourselves as children of Peace and Justice. We talked much about issues regarding with education. We saw how we could engage in the government leaders so that they could act. Then from there, we continued. We called our fellow children from schools across the sub-county. We talked much about education. We told them that we need to change all the changes which have failed to be changed in education sector. And from there, we told them that after that organization, we are going to move forward to the sub-county level so that we can be heard by the government leaders. Then we mobilized ourselves, and then after that, we had a ban and we moved towards the sub-county in the form of a protest. Being many in number was an opportunity for the government leaders to understand what we were intended to do. So they quickly committed themselves and they say that they are going to act upon such issues regarding with education. But we as children, we were also wise. We told them, at least accept two children to be called or to be invited in meetings so that they can represent us and they can monitor whatever you talk about education. Or if you fail to talk about education, we will understand. But we had to put there that issue so that they can choose those two children and represent us. Then also those children who we chose, they were also wiser than them. They kept monitoring whatever was done. They followed all the steps. And it's from that time we had seen a great improvement. The government had been able to employ certain more teachers, at least in 4 primary schools. And there is good performance as I'm talking, whereby the sub-county level has registered at least 65% of children joining secondary school with first and second grades. 15 classroom blocks have been constructed at least in four schools. So as children, we thought that if we wouldn't have done this, we were not going to achieve anything. And we regarded it to our great improvement we fixed in to engage in the government leaders. Ladies and gentlemen, that's why I have given you the example about education. And I request the policymakers to also to see on this issue, so that African children and Europeans and European children can all achieve, because we are fighting for a common goal. I refer remain as Mugisha Johnson. Thank you so much for listening. May the Lord bless you.